Welcome to day 3 of my automail build. Today I am priming all of my armor pieces. Priming is an essential step of the armor making process because most surfaces are not able to be painted right off the bat. Warbla in particular really requires priming before you paint it because it has a very bumpy surface. Unless, of course, you want that bumpy surface to be part of your armor, but most people don't, and specifically for automail, I don't want it. There are two generally accepted methods of priming Warbla, and one of them is gesso, which is used primarily for priming, primarily for priming canvases in the art community. And when it comes to priming Warbla, it usually takes 8 to 10 layers of gesso before you can start sanding. And that takes a long time, and ain't nobody got time for that, in my opinion. So instead, what I'm using is wood glue. And I love this stuff because it only takes 2 to 3 layers, and you don't have to sand it because it dries smoothly. To apply it, all I do is dribble the wood glue on the Warbla piece and then use a paintbrush to spread it around evenly. Right now I'm wrapping up the second layer of wood glue, and while my Warbla pieces are drying, I'm going to go outside and prime the foam pieces. Unlike Warbla, EVA foam does have a smooth surface, but the surface is also porous, which means when you try to paint it, the paint will soak in, and that's just not very efficient. To prime EVA foam, I like to use something called Plastidip, and it comes in a spray version or a brush-on version. I prefer the spray version because it's a lot less messy and it's easier to use. Plastidip basically creates a flexible rubber coating on your armor piece that you can easily paint, and like I said, it's flexible so the piece will be able to bend without cracking. And I promise I'm wearing pants in this video. No, it doesn't look like it, but yep, there they are. This stuff does have pretty strong fumes though, so you definitely want to work outside or at least in a very well-ventilated workshop. I do 2 to 3 layers per piece, and I do all of those layers within 1 hour, so there's no extended dry time between layers. However, I let everything dry for at least 24 hours before I even think of going near it with spray paint. So while the foam is in the garage drying overnight, I'm back upstairs doing my third and final layer of wood glue on the Warbla pieces. For this third layer, I'm not using a paintbrush. I'm instead using my finger and a bit of cold water, which I'll dip my finger in occasionally, and this creates a really smooth surface without any brush strokes, which means I don't have to sand anything, and that's really cool because sanding is awful. Little particles get everywhere, and that's just really annoying, so if I can avoid sanding, I'm definitely going to avoid it. Another reason why wood glue is so awesome for priming Warbla is that it's very cheap. One large bottle will get you through tons of projects and you'll probably still have tons left over. After this third layer is applied, I'm going to let everything dry overnight, just like the foam, and then tomorrow we'll be painting. As always, thanks for tuning in, and feel free to like, comment, subscribe for more cosplay videos, and I will see you in the next installment of this automail build.